In this video, we will look at how to stake a DTM, or a digital terrain model. This is a topographic model that contains a triangulation of elevation data over a spatial area, often used in groundworks or on engineering projects. And we will start by looking at how we select and check a digital terrain model. To select the DTM to use, we need to slide the job carousel all the way to the left and enter into the Choose Design Data screen. Then, within the DTM page tab, we tick the Use a DTM checkbox and then set the DTM job to be used. As we are happy with this job, we can just press OK. We can now use the 3D viewer to check that the DTM covers the area that we expected. However, we must remember that when we go into the 3D viewer, the working job will also be displayed. So we should either use a new, empty working job or one that covers the same area as the DTM. As this is what we have here, we can just enter the 3D viewer. Now initially, the DTM will not be displayed. However, we can turn it on by using the toolbar to enter into the display configuration, then go into the DTM page tab. From here, it is simply a case of ticking the checkbox to turn the DTM on and then setting the color that we want our DTM triangles to be. When we leave the display configuration and return to the 3D viewer, we can clearly see that the triangles of our DTM are in the required area. With our DTM selected and checked, we can now move on to staking to it. To do this, we first need to locate and then select the Stake DTM app from the app carousel. Once inside the app, we are presented with a stake screen. However, until we have a current position, either from GPS or by pressing distance, we do not know what we are trying to stake. Once we have this information, our design height can be computed based on our location within the DTM, and so can our stake value for cut and fill. Then, as we start to move, we can see that even whilst we might stay level, our cut and fill values change as we move around within the DTM. So wherever we move to, we always know the difference between our current height and the design height of the DTM. In some cases, we might need to stake the DTM at specific 2D positions. For this, we can combine staking DTM and staking points together using one app. That app is called Stake Points and DTM, and we will use it right now. Once inside the app, we can see that it's a combination of the Stake DTM screen we've seen in this video and the normal Stake Points screen that we've seen in the Stake Points video. As with normal point staking, we can just tap the point that we want to use. However, we can see that our target for staking and the highlighted point are slightly different. That's because the plan position has come from our points coordinates, whereas the design height is coming through from our DTM. Staking this point will actually be no different from what we covered in the stake points video. So staking to a DTM, to a point, or to a DTM and point is always a relatively simple process thanks to Leica Captivate.